أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أيها الصائمون O people of fasting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us to seek His pleasure and to seek His reward, Jannatul Firdaus, the paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam motivated us to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to seek the Jannat al-Firdaus, and to compete in this way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. In this, to achieve your goal, which is Jannat al-Firdaus, to achieve the greatest reward, Jannat al-Firdaus, so let the competitors compete in this path. Many, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in many ayat, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in many ahadith about Jannah. But I would like to say, the last person will enter Jannah, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in and hadith narrated in Sahih Muslim, آخر من يدخل الجنة رجل. The last person will enter Jannah, a man يمشي مرة ويكبو مرة. A man who would walk once and stumble once. وتسفعه النار مرة. And be burnt by the fire once. فإذا ما جاوزها. When he gets out from the Jannah, from the hellfire, Jahannam, إِلْتَفَتَ إِلَيْهَا, he will turn to it and say, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَجَّانِي مِنْكَ. He will say, blessed is who has saved me from you. لَقَدْ أَعْطَانِ اللَّهُ شَيْئًا مَا أَعْطَاهُ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ. Allah has given me something He hasn't given to anyone, those in earlier or later times. He thinks that no one saved from Jahannam except him. And the ni'mah has given that he was saved from Jahannam is the best and is greatest ni'mah. And no one has given like him. Even after him, no one will be given like him. And he doesn't know the righteous people, al-muttaqeen, al-abrar, al-siddiqeen, الشهداء الصالحين, they already in Jannah years and years ago. He doesn't know. Then the hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَتُرْفَعْ لَهُ شَجَرَةً. A tree would be raised up in front of him. فَيَقُولْ أَيْ رَبِّي, oh my Lord, أَدْنِنِي مِنْ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةً. Let me go close to this tree. Make me closer to this tree. فَلِأَسْتَظِلَّ بِظِلِّهَا وَأَشْرَبَ مِن مَائِهَا. So I can stay under the shade and drink its water. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلُّ. Allah عز وجل will say, يَبْنَ آدَمْ, O son of Adam, لَعَلِّي إِنْ أَعْطَيْتُكَهَا سَأَلْتَنِي غَيْرَهَا. If I gave you this, you will ask me something else. فَيَقُولُ لَا يَا رَبْ. No, يَا رَبْ, O my Lord, just this. وَيُعَاهِدُهُ أَلَّا يَسْأَلَهُ غَيْرَهَا. And he will promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will not ask anything else. وَرَبُّهُ يَعْذُرُهُ. And Allah Azza wa Jal will excuse him. لِأَنَّهُ يَرَى مَا لَا صَبْرَ لَهُ عَلَيْهِ. Because he will see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see, he doesn't have that patience. He doesn't have patience. And he will keep asking. فَيَدْنِيهِ مِنْهَا فَيَسْتَظِلُّ بِظِلِّهَا وَيَشْرَبَ مِنْ مَائِهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him close to the tree, and so he will stay under the shade and will drink from the water. ثُمَّ تُرْفَعْ لَهُ شَجَرَةً هِيَ أَحْسَن مِنَ الْأُولَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise under the shajara tree better than the first one. فَيَقُولُ أَيْ رَبِّ أَدْنِنِي مِنْ هَذِهِ. Oh my Lord, bring me closer to this tree. لِأَشْرَبَ مِنْ مَائِهَا وَأَسْتَظِلَّ بِظِلِّهَا. So I can drink from its water and I can stay under the shade. لَا أَسْأَلُكَ غَيْرَهَا. I will not ask you anything else after that. فَيَقُولُ يَبْنَ آدَمْ, O son of Adam, أَلَمْ تُعَاهِدْنِي أَلَّا تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرَهَا. Did you not promise me that you will not ask anything else? فَيَقُولُ لَحَلِّي إِنْ أَدْنَيْتُكَ مِنْهَا تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرَهَا. Allah will say, if I bring you here again, then you will ask again and you'll ask something else. فَيُعَاهِدُهُ أَلَّا يَسْأَلَهُ غَيْرَهَا. He will promise again that he will not ask anything else after that. وَرَبُّهُ يَعْذُرُهُ. And his Lord, the Lord of the creation, يَعْذُرُهُ, he will excuse him. لِأَنَّهُ يَرَى مَا لَا صَبْرَ لَهُ عَلَيْهِ. Because Allah knows that he can't be patient and he will keep asking. فَيْدْنِيهِ مِنْهَا فَيَسْتَظِلَّ بِظِلِّهَا وَيَشْرَبَ مَائِهَا. Then Allah will bring him to the next tree, the second tree, and he will have the drink water, and then he will stay on the shade. ثُمَّ تُرْفَعْ لَهُ شَجَرَةٌ عِنْدَ بَابِ الْجَنَّةِ. Then Allah will raise a tree in front of the gates of Jannah. He can't see the Jannah, but he will see the tree in front of the gate of the Jannah. هِيَ أَحْسَنْ مِنَ الْأُولَيَيْنِ. This tree, the third tree, is better than the first and second one. فَيَقُولُ أَيْ رَبِّ. Oh my Lord, he can't be patient. Oh my Lord, أَدْنِنِي مِنْ هَذِي. أَدْنِنِي مِنْ هَذِي. Make me closer to this. لِأَسْتَظِلَّ بِظِلِّهَا وَأَشْرَبَ مِنْ مَائِهَا. So I can't drink from the water and I stay under the shade. لَا أَسْأَلُكَ غَيْرَهَا. I will not ask you after that. فَيَقُولُ يَبْنَ آدَمْ. Oh son of Adam, أَلَمْ تُعَاهِدْنِي أَلَّا تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرَهَا. Did you not promise me that you will not ask again something else? قَالَ بَلَى. Yes, my Lord, يَا رَبِّ. هَذِهِ. Just this. لَا أَسْأَلُكَ غَيْرَهَا. I will not ask anything after that. وَرَبُّهُ يَعْذُرُهُ. And his Lord will excuse him. He knows لَا صَبْرَ لَهُ مَا لَا صَبْرَ لَهُ عَلَيْهَا. Because he doesn't have patience. He will keep asking. فَيَدْنِيهِ مِنْهَا. And then Allah will make him closer to that third tree. فَإِذَا أَذْنَاهَ. When he's going to be under the third tree, سَمِعَ صَوْتَ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. He will hear the people of Jannah, the voice of people of Jannah, and the enjoyment in the Jannah, and the voice coming out from the Jannah. سَمِعَ أَصْوَاتَ الْجَنَّةِ. فَيَقُولُ أَيْ رَبِّ. Oh my Lord, أَدْخِلْنِيهَا. Enter me to it. Admit me to in the Jannah. أَدْخِلْنِيهَا. فَيَقُولُ يَبْنَ آدَمْ. Oh son of Adam, مَا يُصْرِينِي مِنْكْ. مَا يَقْطَعُنِي مِنْكْ. How can this end? You keeping asking again and again. أَيُرْضِيكَ أَنْ أُعْطِيكَ الدُّنْيَا وَمِثْلَهَا. أَيُرْضِيكَ أَنْ أُعْطِيكَ الدُّنْيَا وَمِثْلَهَا. Will it be please you if I give you the whole world and the like one along with it? أَيُرْضِيكَ أَنْ أُعْطِيكَ الدُّنْيَا وَمِثْلَهَا مَعَهَا. قَالَ يَا رَبِّ. Oh my Lord, أَتَسْتَهْزِئُ مِنِّي وَأَنْتَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Are you mocking at me and you Lord of the creation? أَتَسْتَهْزِئُ مِنِّي وَأَنْتَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Are you mocking at me and you the Lord of the creations? And who narrated the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. He said, فَضَحِكَ ابْنُ مَسْعُود. Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه laughed. فَقَالَ. He said, ابْنُ مَسْعُود, أَلَا تَسْأَلُونَنِي مِمَّا أَضْحَكْ. Will you not ask me why I'm laughing in this point? فَقَالُ مِمَّا تَضْحَكْ. They asked him, Tabi'in, why you are laughing, Ibn Mas'ud? قَالَ هَكَذَا ضَحِكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَمْ. This is how Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم laughed in this point. And then Sahaba asked him, مِمَّ تَضْحَكْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Why are you laughing, O Prophet, Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم? فَقَالَ مِنْ ضَحْكِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Well, because Allah, the Lord of the creation, will laugh at this point. حين قال, when this person said, أَتَسْتَهْزِئُ مِنِّي وَأَنْتَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Are you mocking at me and you Lord of the creations? Allah will laugh. The Prophet ﷺ laughed and Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه laughed. فَيَقُولُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply, إِنِّي لَا أَسْتَهْزِئُ. I'm not mocking at you. لَكِنِّي عَلَى مَا أَشَاءُ قَادِرٌ. لكن whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, whatever I want to give, I have power to give. And whatever I will give. And I have power. Qadir or Qadir. And one of the hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فإذا دخلها, when this person, the last person will enter Jannah and he will come out from Jahannam, قال الله له تمنى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, تمنى, seek, ask something, wish whatever you like, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فيسأل ربه, he will ask whatever he likes, ويتمنى. حتى إن الله, Allah عز وجل will remind him, ليذكره من كذا وكذا, you forgot to mention this, say this, ask this, وكذا وكذا. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, you forgot to mention this, you didn't ask that, ask Allah this. And he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he won't have anything to ask. Allah will remind him to ask these and that. حتى إذا انقطعت به الأماني قال الله لك مثله وما. I will give you this and double for this. Extra, everything you will be rewarded for, double and extra. This is how Na'im al-Jannah. This is how Na'im al-Jannah. And this is the last person will enter Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him all of these. And this is last person will come out from hellfire, will enter Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will treat him like this. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also, he said, in Yawm al-Qiyamah, when the last person will come out from Jahannam and will enter Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will سأعرض عليه صغار ذنوبه. Place his minor sins and show his minor sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ورفع, will say ورفع عنه كبارها, and major sins will hide it and don't show it. فتعرض عليه صغار ذنوبه, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show him his minor sins. فيقال له, and Allah will ask him, عملت كذا وكذا في يوم كذا وكذا, you did so and so, and on that day you did certain things in this muharramat, and all this is minor sins. So he will say, "Na'am, yes." He can't deny. لا يستطيع أن ينكر وهو مشفق من كبار ذنوبه. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking him about minor sins, he will be scared and afraid. That imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking him about the major sins. But Allah will say, "فإن لك مكان كل سيء." Every single سيء, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace it to حسنة. Allah will replace this minor sins to حسنات, reward. Then he will say, he was afraid about major sins. He will say, Ya Rabbi, قد عملت أشياء لا أراها هنا. I did so many things, major sins, I can't see it here, because he wants his major sins to be حسنات. Ya Allah, like how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. فلقد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ضحك حتى بدت. Like I saw the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he mentioned this hadith, he was laughing. And this is Na'im of Jannah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, As'aluka na'iman la yanfad. The na'im Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never ends, which is Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ma indakum yanfad. Whatever you have, yanfad, will end and finish. Wa ma indallahi baq. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, it will stay forever and never ends. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. This Jannah, نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ألا إن سلعة الله غالية, ألا إن سلعة الله الجنة. سلعة الله غالية. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he will grant you Jannah, he will grant you with your actions, by his mercy. Without actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you cannot enter Jannah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and did righteous deeds, عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, لَهُمْ جَنَّاتِ. وَنُودُوا أَن تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةُ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. It will be called in Yawm al-Qiyamah to enter Jannah. Bima kuntum ta'amaloon. What you used to do, good deeds, righteous deeds, your obligatory and your voluntaries. So you need amal to enter Jannah. And you don't stay with mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're hoping the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. But you act, you do your actions, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will enter Jannah. You will pass the hardships that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surrounded Jannah. When he said, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ. Jannah is surrounded with hardships. You need to pass these hardships and difficulties. You wake up for Fajr. You pray your salah. You walk to the masjid. You have the attachment with deen, with ilm, with knowledge, with Quran, with sunnah of Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you stay away from shahawat, desires, because the nar is surrounded with shahawat, desires. Easy to enter Jahannam, because whenever you follow your desires, you'll enter Jahannam easily. But al-Jannah bil-makareh, hardships, and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. You worship Him, you follow His commandments, and you follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The last point is Laylatul Qadr. In the last 10 days of Ramadan, or last 10 nights of Ramadan, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man qama Laylatul Qadr imana wa ihtisaba. Whoever worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prayed on that night, Laylatul Qadr, imana wa ihtisaba, believing Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and seeking the reward of Laylatul Qadr, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. His sins will be forgiven, his previous sins will be forgiven. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Surah Al-Qadr about Laylatul Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr wa ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr khayrun. This night is better than min alfi shahr, 1,000 months. Just one night, few hours you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So strive hard in this blessed month. The doors of Jannah is still open. Still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees people from hellfire. Still you have the best opportunity in the last month, in the last 10 days and nights of Ramadan. You still have so much time in the month of Ramadan. So take this opportunity and do not waste your time and seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Jannah. The last point I would like to say, that some brothers, they stay in the back when we start the khutbah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, like people of Jannah, whoever comes closer to the Imam, he will enter Jannah early. And whoever stay in the back, he will enter Jannah later. And some ahadith says years and years later he will enter Jannah. And some ahadith say 40 years he will stay and wait until he enter Jannah. Why? Because he used to stay in the back. So don't waste these virtues just to you want to go quickly, or you want to leave the masjid quickly after the salah, because you're missing that virtues. You're missing the virtues that you come closer to the Imam and you listen to the khutbah. So just come closer to the Imam and take the virtues, and honor them. Sometimes harm other people to come closer to the Imam because they stay in the back after you when you come and you block the space. So I hope everyone understand this point. ألا وصلوا وسلموا على من أمركم الله بالصلاة والسلام عليه فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أذل الشرك والمشركين اللهم دمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم انصر عبادك الموحدين اللهم انصر عبادك الموحدين في كل مكان اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم طهر المسجد الأقصى من اليهود الغاصبين اللهم أخرجهم منه أذلة صاغرين اللهم نصرك الذي وعدت عبادك المؤمنين يا قوي يا عزيز اللهم عالم الغيب والشهادة فاطر السماوات والأرض أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون اهدنا لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام.